Let him do his thing. I'm recording y'all right now. I'm recording it right now.
Go get the guy. Go pull the flag. Go run. Go, 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 go get him, Roman. Go get him.
Boy, he's got some speed.
That's my boy. He's fast.
We'll try to get him.
We go.
Move that.
That's the cake.
It's a big ass cake.
It's a big ass cake.
Hey, 3.5 years ago on this day, we did announce Brayden's shoes pregnant. He reminded me of that.
That's awesome, bro.
Fist bump. And go get the Moet out the fridge, though. Fist bump. Hey, squirrel, what are you sweating, bro?
Because, man, I'm nervous.
So this is my dad's property that we just acquired 6 or 7 months ago. He was needing to move out of Round Rock to get a little closer, lower his payment. And so we found this. It's 3 acres. Built that fence over there. It's got a pond. It's drying up though. It's a double wide. Needs some work. We're gonna get to that. There's a lot of things on this property that have to still be done, and a lot of it's being put off because I need to finish that thing over there. There's the trailer. That's where I work on them. It's a big RV carport looking deal. And we just thought it was perfect. As you can see, it's the super tall carport deal. And That's where it gets done for now. You know, we got a whole shop set up. Sometimes it's organized. Most of the time it's not. But, I mean, this is the real deal. You know, current office space. Dabby getting in his wheelchair and trying to help out inside. Anyway, so here's the current rig. Let me get a better shot of the front. And I've got before pictures. Basically, this is a 2006 Gulfstream. It was a FEMA trailer. FEMA built or contracted to have however many thousand of these built during Katrina and other disasters. So now there's a bunch of them on the market, which if all goes well, I'd like to kind of stick with this style of trailer. I'd like to also get into the vintage trailers, which are the older kind of classic looks, different curves and features on those older RVs that, you know, they're vintage 60s and 70s and stuff that we could turn into some really cool trailers, food trailers. I'd also like to get into the mini house kind of concept and the super kind of custom campers, tailgate rigs. All of that is part of my plan. On this one, I put a front porch. I cut the whole wall out right here, as you can see, and put that whole wall in, and that door and that window and the chalkboard menu. That was just open. There was none of that was there. This window was not there. Cut that out. And then I cut this whole thing out. Got some steps that aren't completely finished, but those are gonna hinge up right here. Be some big hinges. And the whole steps will fold up and latch. And there'll be an awning that comes down and latches. But customers will be able to come in here, and I've got some cedar that I cut way over there. As you can see, probably all the cedar. Where is it at? Yeah, way over there. Cedar stumps and stuff. I'm gonna use a few of those. I'm gonna put them in here along the this countertop here and make it to where it's got some seating. So there'll be a couple stools custom mounted to match the the look I have there. All right, bringing some natural into the customization. So I've got all this was typical RV, you know, this was not all wooded out like you see. Any craftsman is gonna appreciate the quality of what I'm doing here with this grain and these intricate cuts. You know, it's not just me throwing some equipment in a box and calling it a food trailer. I'm actually doing a lot of custom work that, like I say, any wood guy or any craftsman guy is gonna go, okay, this guy's putting it in. You can see all the different tones in the grain. That's what I'm proud of, is when I start getting into this woodwork. In my opinion, the stainless concept, where, you know, all the inside, everything is all metal, and, you know, outside is metal and it's either wrapped or one solid color. That's just your typical food trailer. I mean, I'm trying to provide an option, a different style, a home style feel, woodwork, customization, and then giving the clients the ability to choose what they have inside as far as cooking equipment. So when looking through the market and trailers that are available, there's nothing that's going to look like this. There's nothing that's going to have fold-up stairs that are made from what used to be couch brackets. And no one's putting roofing material down as your detail work on the outside and framing in signage and doing what I'm doing. It's just not happening out there in the market. So just there's a little 360 view of that trailer, and there's more to come. And then there's Dad. He's over here piddling with something. There's the cabinet doors. They're gonna go on. And this guy, you can't keep him down. He's gonna do work no matter what. What are you working on?
I'm gonna cut a piece of cable over here.
Oh, okay. So anyway, it's nonstop stuff that we're having to do over here because, you know, we bought the property and the house needs a lot of work, and we're just trying to get it all done while still trying to juggle kids and family and working, and it's just real life tied into this cool concept of taking an RV that is basically busted and old and beat up and turning it into something that someone will pay a lot of money for, that then turns into a business that makes them money. So I think that's a cool transition, and a lot of work on my part and a lot of stress, but I love it, you know. And I've done real estate and I've done all these other different things, and this is what I really love, because I get to work with my hands and kind of produce something that's artistic, that someone appreciates to the point of paying me $20,000 or $30,000. And you know, so there you go, more videos to come. I'm under the cabinets just trying to build some braces for some shelves, and as you can see, it's kind of a crawl space and kind of a pain in my ass, but getting it done. Need to add some more pieces, and I'm gonna have a platform that follows what this will be, a platform that goes all the way down, you know, and it'll end up matching like it is down there, all grayed out. But storage shelf, and I'm gonna bring it all the way down, and then I'll probably leave this little cubby open, but all this will look nice and uniform, and it'll have doors, and it'll look real good with these faux granite countertops. Solid. Now it can hold shit. Well, not quite, but got the platform in. Throw some plywood across there. Make it look right. While Dad's over there working, I mean, amputee, and he works harder now than he did before. It's crazy. He really doesn't, can't sit still. He's freaking pressure washing his house. God. Making cuts. Making cuts.
So what are you doing inside?
What am I doing inside? Working on this ventilation region of the trailer. I've got to like level out where that register's at with wood around it, kind of frame it in to where I have a level surface to attach the screen. And then I'll probably figure out some kind of way to put some hinges on this to where it'll open and close, kind of like a cabinet door. Or put it into a wooden frame that does that. Maybe a slide in something, yeah. It's got to be air, you know, airtight.
Okay, so this thing is going to have to leak, and what it needs to be, 1.25 inches.
Keep it on for a few minutes.
Hmm. You want to talk? You can talk. If you want to ask questions,
I don't want to add no damn question. Ah, there's the tool. It has now become a drill. It was just a second ago a circular saw. My fingers were getting in the screen, he said. Yeah.
So what we have here is going to be the front angled piece that folds down on the ventilation. It's going to be completely covered in stainless, but this is all the framework for the vent screens that'll go in these holes. Basically, they'll be removable, some kind of slide feature that'll let them slide into place so they can be pulled out and cleaned. There's that. That'll mount on the inside. Once it's all covered in metal, once this is all covered in metal, it'll go right here. It'll hinge and it'll open so that the inside can be cleaned. The screens can be pulled out. The screen that'll be over this can be pulled out. They can all be washed daily, you know, whatever. Keep it all from caking up. All right, so currently I'm on the front patio area working on outlet. That wire is gonna, I'm gonna put an outlet right here. It's gonna come through the ceiling panel and connect over here to a switch. It's gonna get its power from the same thing. And then this is gonna be a switch that turns on the light, the fluorescent lights over there. So that's what I'm working on right now. Basically going to splice these wires together so it's long enough to go through the ceiling. Got to use the right size caps, otherwise it won't be a good hold. Damn it. And just to be extra secure, always put, so that the caps don't come off, some electrical tape around each one. And then just basically just cover up the whole thing. You know, they're going to go in the ceiling, so they're going to be there for forever. You know, if anything were to ever happen, ceiling leak or something, you want them to be protected completely. And you don't want it to ever yank apart or anything going down the road. So you make it happen like that. So now I can put it through the roof here over this doorway to come through on the other side and drop down and be able to reach where I'm going to connect it to the other switch and stuff. Basically, the power is coming from over there, so gotta get it through here.
But I love how you painted the trailer.
Yeah.
Because it's dark blue, like our favorite colors. But you should have painted the trailer black. Because it looks cooler in black. Yeah, it does.
Okay. I painted one black already.
Oh, you mean the one with the one with the alligators?
Alligators?
Yeah, the one with the alligators.
Pond?
Yeah.
I didn't say anything about a pond. I said I painted one black. A trailer. What are you talking about?
In a woods with a pond with alligators.
Oh. Yes, the place where I was building it.
Yeah.
Yeah. There was no alligators. I was just messing with you. That's fun.
Oh, you were just messing with me that there was alligators in that pond?
Yes. That was a joke. God, this is a pain in my ass. I guess I could put the angle on. Actually see what I'm doing. Full ceiling view. Opposite, bass, snare, bass, snare. No, don't even worry about that. Bass, snare, bass, snare. Bass, snare, bass, snare. Yeah, but you have to have the bass and the snare. Opposite. Boom, boom, boom. You do the bass in between the snare. So at the end of today, we got the ceiling panels in the back done. Got the lights tested and all the electrical cleaned up. I moved the thermostat wires and stuff over here so I can mount it to that wall. Shortened up all the wires and cleaned all those up a little bit. I now know where all my LED lights are gonna hang from. Get some ceiling panels. Got that one in the front. So really it's just the middle panels around the AC. Which kind of have to wait till I put the AC in. And the whole ceiling will be paneled. And then I can trim it out and paint it all white to match. And finish the metal in the back. All the stainless or aluminum, whatever I'm going to go with. I don't know yet. And then the FRP, I added a panel there. I need to add the white FRP all the way down to the window. So we've got the sinks and cabinets almost finished up. You can see they've got a gloss over them, a varnish, and you can see the grain real good. Big sinks are in. I'm gonna go ahead and put a drain board right here that attaches and has a slant stainless drain board. We'll put some shelves and some drying rack hooks here. Still got ceiling panels to go in. Then you got the hand sink right here. And the rest of the countertop is open for whatever use. Got the 30 amp electrical system there. Got access to that plumbing. Got access to that plumbing. And the water tank and the water feeds and the pump and the drain all in one nice area. Then you have large, still a little bit of paint work to do, but got a large storage area there. Buyer could have me divide that up or put in little perimeter walls or more shelves in any of this if need be. Go ahead and stain that to match right there. I'm also going to stain around the window to match the gray. Be an end cap right there on that. All the cosmetic stuff is happening. On this wall, I've got a fridge here now on this platform. It could be replaced with anything that you need. This empty space could be utilized for more refrigeration or freezer or prep area or pizza topping bar or sandwich prep, you know, a range with another vent hood could go there. Whatever the customer needs, this is going to be where the cooking area is, where I'm going to install the custom ventilation all through here. And that's the next big project. So, but the buyer's going to be able to decide what actually goes in that area. I'll have all the gas valves ran and the shutoffs. I'm going to put the same FRP paneling across here that I have in the wash area, the white, all the way down. You won't see any of that. Any exposed wood will be painted and or stained. And of course, the highlight of this rig is the front porch. A lot of contrasting wood gray. What's up, Dad? What are you doing?
Drinking water. Well, I'm done. Picking up trash that you left on the ground.
Yes. This is the service window. They're going to be able to see the action inside. Wait for their food. There's the menu board. We got the opening where the customers will come up. I'm going to have some stumps here, made out of cedar to match the braces. And these stairs will fold all the way up and latch and close all this in, as well as an awning will come down and close and latch so we can go down the road. I will also have an awning on this side that'll close and latch and lock from the inside. So there you go. Let's go down here and out the outside a little bit. Again, still some finishing touches to do. Put a couple more coats of clear on the all around the on all the wood. Paint the inside of the two sign areas white, and then we'll cover that with a plexiglass so they can the buyers will be able to apply a decal very easily for their company logo. Almost done. Just got through staining and varnishing the remaining part of the cabinets up here. Let's say it came out pretty good. Got that good grain. All around the window as well. I mean, it's still wet. So all we gotta do is a few more finishing touches in here. Good to go. Well, I'm a happy guy right now. I've been messing with the AC. Got the new AC unit in. I mean, cosmetically, it's not all finished, but the motor's running. It's cooling. It's great.
I've got the thermostat moved. It's gonna be hanging like right here. It'll be over here somewheres. And so yeah, the new unit is in and going. That's a good thing. Another good thing is that we just acquired the buyer. They just came, they looked at the trailer, they gave me a deposit. So all goes well. I'm not gonna say who it is yet, but we will have a you know, local business owner who has multiple locations utilizing this trailer as what he puts out front of his new location that he's opening up to start the business going in that location ahead of it being opened in the building. And then he'll be able to use the trailer to do that, to open up more businesses, more locations over and over again. It's a coffee shop business. I'm not gonna say who yet, but basically, you know, it looks like we have a buyer. So altogether, a good day. All right, so we got a little update. Last portion of the video I made, I disclosed that we do have a buyer. The buyer is the owner of a local number of coffee shops. I don't want to say who yet, but you know, when it's all final, said and done, I'll put out images and pictures of it, you know, all logoed out at his new location. So because of this, the cooking area that I was going to make happen doesn't need to happen. They're not cooking anything. There's no gas valves or shutoffs or anything for the gas lines or the metal. The metal doesn't need to be there. I mean, I've already got the ventilation up there, the big vent fan, but it's not required. So now they're just going to have a cool, you know, way to vent out some heat if they need to. Anyway, so instead of the cooking area, what they require is more counter space. They wanted another service window and countertops and cabinets, because they need space for all of their equipment instead of cooking stuff. And then also they need some 220 electrical. So now I'm gonna have to run some 220 electrical as well as another 50 amp system, because you know, with all their equipment, they're gonna require 60, 50, and then the 30 amp regular RV system that contains the AC. You know, they're gonna require 140 amps. We're gonna have to put them on a 200 amp meter at the location, branch off with three outlets, one being a 60 amp 220 four wire, the other outlet being a 50 amp 110 and then the 30 amp 110 to run everything. So we're having to bulk up the electrical for their equipment instead of gas lines and metal for a cooking area. So here's what I've already done. Bam, cut out the spot for the new window, because they're going to have a drive-through. They're going to be able to have cars pull up right here and order out of that window. And I've already structured out new cabinets and laid the countertop on there. So this is where they'll put espresso machine, coffee maker, big machines, pull a lot of electrical, put a new outlet box and everything down there. And then they can serve out of this window, and they can serve out of the patio. I mean, so, but it's going to be good. I got to cut out this portion of the backsplash. We'll put the window right in there. It's going to be just like this window. And we've still got the furnace covered up there. It was just on the end here. I'm going to do some little shelves or something like that. I'm not sure yet. There you go. In the back where the cooking and ventilation was going to happen on all the metal, now we don't need all that. So I'm going to put some stainless shelves right here, and they're going to put their fridge right here. And that's going to be fridge, drying racks, right on the other side of where all the sinks are at. So there you go. More video, pictures, and who is the actual
I'm Yeah, but he was just saying how cool it is, you know, being able to, you know, working with you guys, being able just to hang out at coffee shops, you know, have a cool atmosphere.
Yeah.
Found Donald and Amanda was like, yes, I love that chair. That thing is awesome. You know, she loved it. So,
cool.
So we called him up.
This is cool.
Makes me, you know, feel pretty good that just anyone, one person
man.
Likes it.
Yeah, man. Oh, hey, so. Yeah, that's pretty high praise from Dean, and I think that's pretty sweet.
Well, I do appreciate it.
All right, folks, I just wanted to say thank you to Summer Moon for becoming a client. Appreciate the hat. Summer Moon Coffee, wood-fired coffee over on Main Street in Buda. We'll also now be located out on 290 in Oak Hill. Well, between Oak Hill and Dripping Springs, you can find them around 290 and Fitzhugh. They're going to open up a whole new shop, but the trailer is actually going to be open at that location ahead of the brick and mortar being finished. So please go check out Summer Moon, become a customer. Wanted to thank Summer Moon for becoming a client of mine. Hope we can do future business. And I just wanted to put together a little video to show, you know, what we put together for Summer Moon. And I just wanted to say how awesome I think it is that it can stay local. And now we've got a couple different businesses working locally together, and that to me is exactly what I want to do. So, Austin Custom Mobile Kitchens on Facebook, and please visit Summer Moon Coffee. And check it out. This is the back porch, front porch, and it is all tongue and groove on the walls and on the floor. Got a bar top on two sides. Folks can sit here and drink their coffee, eat their breakfast, charge their phones, sit on the custom built cedar stools. And these are mobile, so during transport, they can be moved to the back because they're pretty heavy. You've got a cable jack. If there's ever a need for a TV, you got cable ran to the trailer. Couple different outlets, got the LED lights, two awnings, and of course the full downstairs. Got a chalkboard menu and the service window. And of course a view to the inside so customers can watch as their coffee or their breakfast being prepared. Custom built cabinets, lots of storage, hand sink, and you got your triple basins required by most health departments. Got some shelves for drying, and this whole area back here is waterproof. Have a additional 100 amp system here. We've got breakers for regular outlets, and we've got a couple 220 breakers that are meant for the coffee brewers, which will go over here to this side and hook up
to these bigger outlets that are under here. So all that's prepared for the big coffee brewing machines. We've got a lot more counter space over here, and then this is a drive-through window. They're gonna actually have cars pulling up to, which is pretty cool. First drive-through trailer, probably. Of course, we installed some custom drawers. Built from scratch. And we got us a custom trash can right here. Just throw your trash bag in it. Similar to this on the back. Guys, please check out Summer Moon Wood Fired Coffee on Main Street in Buda. The new location is going to be on 290. Please check them out. Also, check out Austin Custom Mobile Kitchens on Facebook.